Hi guys, this is Renu and today I'm just describing noun. Okay, so let's discuss this noun. Okay, so the noun is a word which denotes a person, any living being, a place, a thing, and an idea. So the words thought by the parents to their kids are mostly nouns. So singular and plural forms of nouns. Most of the nouns of singular form change to plural forms by adding the letters, like mother, mothers, girl, girls, pen, pens, book, books, hand, hands, speak, speaks, school, schools, road, roads, car, car, cycle, cycle. So nouns ending in s, sh, ch, xz get the plural form by adding es at the end of the words. Bus, buses. Okay, bush, bushes. Branch, branches. Box, boxes. Toppers, toppers. For singular noun ending with y, if the preceding letter of the y is consonant, then replace ies instead of y. So for singular nouns ending with y, if the preceding letter of the y is vowel, then replace as instead of y. Like city, cities. Okay, body, bodies. We have to remove here y. Boy, boys, but not here because there is a before is a vowel given. Okay, toy, toys. So if a singular noun end in o preceded by a vowel, add s at the end of the words. Radio, radios. Studio, studios. Bamboo, bamboos. Cuckoo, cuckoos. Okay, so radio, so we have to put here s. studio, so we have to put here s. Bamboo, put s. Cuckoo, s. So if a singular noun ends in g o preceded by a consonant, add es at the end of the words. Potato, potatoes. Echo, echoes. Tomato, tomato. So what is the exceptions here? Exceptions of technical and scientific words, even if the ending letter O is preceded by consonants, as only added in the plural form. Dynamo, dynamos. Piano, pianos. Memento, memento. So the following words are rather typical and they do not fall under any of the rules detailed above. Son-in-law, sons-in-law. Brother-in-law, brothers-in-law. Mouse, mice. Foot, feet. Men, men. Okay, man, men. Tooth, teeth. Cattle, cattle. Sheep, sheep. So these are nouns, plural nouns and singular nouns. Now let's talk about common noun. So what is a common noun, guys? Common noun is that. So what is a common noun, guys? A word of a noun which denotes in common to every person or everything of the same kinds or class is defined as a common noun. Okay, example, Asia is a continent. So continent is a common noun and continent is a word applicable to any other continent. London is the capital of England. So capital is applicable to any other capital. So capital is a common noun. So do you know what is the meaning of common noun? Common noun like a pencil, razor. Okay, like a things, it's called a common noun. Gender also called a common noun. Okay, like lady, like bus. Okay, like girl, boy, uncle, aunt. These all are common noun. What is a proper noun, guys? Proper noun, a proper noun is a name of a particular person, place or thing. So word of proper noun is always written with a capital letter as a first letter of the word. Okay, example, Asia is a continent. So Asia is a proper noun and Asia represents a particular continent and London is the capital of England. So these words are applicable only to a particular city in the country respectively. So London and England are proper nouns. So what is the abstract noun? An abstract noun is a noun which usually denotes a quality, actions or state without reference to the object to the which it pertains. So example, kindness, hearted, honesty, bravery, laughter, childhood, youth, music, obedience, growth. Okay, so these are abstract noun. What is a collective noun, guys? A word denoting a number of persons or things taken together but spoken of as one is a collective noun. Example, every nation maintains its own army. So army is a collective noun. My uncle is in the village owns a herd of sheep. So that is a herd, sheep of. Okay, many sheep are there, so that is a herd of sheep. During Sundays, we see a big crowd on a marina beach. So that is a crowd, means people of, group of people, that is called a crowd. Okay, so army means the number of soldiers, or herd means the number of sheep, and crowd means the number of people. So these words in capital letters are called collective nouns, guys. Okay, what is a compound noun? Compound noun, two or more nouns combined to form a singular noun and a function as a singular noun. Such a noun is called a compound noun. Example, the bus driver drives carefully. A school teacher resides in our apartment. Mango fruit juice is very tasty. And the bus conductor is cordial to the passenger. Okay, so let's talk about countable nouns. Countable nouns are the names of people, objects, etc. that we can count. Okay, we can't count. So we can count what or whom the said words denote. So countable noun we can count, but uncountable noun we cannot count. So first we talk about countable noun. Book, friend, brother, teacher, doctor, cow, tree, mango. These are all countable noun. Books, okay, pencil box, razor, like these are all countable noun. So what is a countable? Uncountable. Uncountable nouns are the things that we cannot count. Stars, water, soil, sunshine, snow. These all are uncountable. Wheat, rice, oil. Okay, these all are uncountable. What is a material noun? Material noun refers to a material or substance from which things are made. Silver, gold, iron, cotton, diamond, and plastic. That is called a material noun. So guys, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel, press the like button, and thank you guys for watching this video. Okay.